Welcome, guys and girls, to Sigro, the World of Miniatures. My name is Sven, and right now we're here to paint this small dwarf. We'll put him, after painting, on the base, and I will lead you through the whole painting process. This is the first video for me in English, so I hope you can enjoy it, and we have all fun together. So there we are. This picture, this miniature, I like it because it have a lot of details, nice work, the resin have good quality, no problems at all at the miniature. So the whole painting process will be very, very good. And we have a few colors. I will inform you which colors I used always. And we'll put it also inside the whole video. And this is the first video in English, so please don't be too hard to me. It's just the first time. Okay, this is the base. I will put it on it, and it have to look good. And I always created stories for my miniatures. This miniature, this dwarf, went to the north and is a hunter, and I will tell you what he is hunting in a few seconds. The first step before is to just dry brush the miniature on every part, so it's easier to see the details for the next painting steps. I dry brushed the parts of the miniature and the color I like the miniature to be in the future. Like here, I used a small pigment of Beastie Brown from Vallejo. Just a few pigments on the dry brush. Here, the dry brush is a makeup brush. Then I moved over to the fur. The fur have to be a little bit more white. That's why I used the magic color I like. It's silver gray from Vallejo. It's a model color. And this silver gray have to be added on the fur, on the whole fur. Because the fur is from a wolf from the north, a winter wolf or snowy wolf, however you will tell. And he hunted this wolf to bring it home to his home village. That is not in the north, it's more in the middle of a continent. We will see, I don't know. But that's the whole story. He is a hunter, and that's why the fur will stick out from the whole miniature and base. Okay, and the weapon, just dry brush the weapon with a mix of black and white from Vallejo, Deaf White and Necro Black. To have a nice gray, I don't use gray tones at all. And this was a size comparison. You can just pause it, so you see it's the same size as a normal Space Marine. You can use it for every tabletop game. The whole miniature is created from the German brand Pasch Spiele. I will link the shop in the description. Beautiful miniatures, beautiful way of getting them because they are sending very fast. They are cheap, good products at all. Okay, the fur, you see it's white right now. We will step over to the next parts very, very easily. The fur have silver gray, like I said, with a mixture of a little bit white. You have to be very, very careful with silver gray, a model color, because model colors are always very fluid. That's why you have to paint over and over and over again to have a good layer. Also, if you just shake the color always. If you shake it, you have better color pigments from the among of pigments in the color drops you put on your wet palette. But it's always very fluid. And you will lose a lot of color after dry period of drying. So we have to use it over and over again. That's why I put some white also into the silver gray. Okay, after painting the fur, I moved over to the head of the wolf. Right now it looks very, very hard. You have always the parts by painting miniatures where you just can, yeah, if you ask me, you can just feel like you throw up to the because of the looking of the miniature. It looks so awful at the beginning always. But after a few hours of working, you see there the miniature growing on the special places. Okay, after painting everything in a silver gray white mix, deaf white mix, I washed it the first time using bone white. Bone white is darker. Bone white is normally used by me for paper in a mix with brown and other colors. Right now I will put bone white on it because it's darker and will leave the pigments of the color in the, like, I don't know, in the canyons of the fur, the down parts. You have up parts of the fur that's very, very up high. Like if you by example think over a hill, you have the up part of the hill, you have the down part. Yes, and the pigments will put themselves in the down parts, and then this is an example, right? This is what happened after. It's more gray. The whole silver gray is lost. Not the whole, but a lot of them. So you have to paint the highlights again. But first I thought, oh no, it's awful. But after a few minutes painting the highlights again, I thought that this looks better now. As in the beginning, where everything was shiny and just white. Now you have not only white places. Good, right now we've come to the end of this back part painting. Enough time for painting this back part. There are just a few steps now to just leave it there like it is. Never touch it again. We have to put some wash on the back, on the fur that will let some highlights stick out. So I choose a mix of non-oil mixed with a little bit black, abandoned black from Citadel, both products. Yes, non-oil is always good to wash your fixture and to work out some very special highlights, but you can have this problem I have right now. It's shiny, it's glossy. I never used non-oil gloss for these types of clothes, but if you use too much non-oil normal, you have also the problem that it's glossy and I hate it. So I put a very matte varnish on it. The Mary Watt matte varnish is a varnish from, let me search. From AK Interactive, there it is. Ultra Varnish Matte. Matte. From AK Interactive. And here you can see it drying. Good. After the first dry, just work out the highlights again. Take a dry brush, put some very, very few white pigments on it, and you will have some very special highlights. And the whole thing looks better now. So we use just a few colors. Deaf white, model color, silver gray, bone white, non-oil, and a varnish. Okay, we can turn it. Turn it to the upper side. And we have the inside of the skin. And the inside is very less of detail. You have just a very smooth overlay. And I choose some gray I mix from white and black. From black Negro black from Vallejo and Death White. Because the normal gray color I have here in my bottle is not the color I want. And with the mixing I can choose the white and black parts and can work better where the shadow of the miniature will be if you put the light on top of it. There are a few miniatures when I turn it down, I look at the head and my point of view is the light, and if you do this you see which part have to be more shiny than the other part. And that's why I choose a very normal gray to work out, like you see here, to work out the dark and shiny parts after this. And there are no specific leather details in the miniature itself, in the material. There are a lot of people that will say, okay, work it out. But I just leave it with a small detail here and there, and that's it. Always work a little bit of glazing. The colors are wet. You can put the next color next to it. They will work together very good. Okay, after this back part, we are finished now. God bless, we are finished now. I moved over to the leather parts. You see it here. The leather, the boots are dark at the top, shiny at the end. Leather have specific behaviors. They touch metal, they will rubber off, like leaving a color. And if the sun is shining on them, it's shiny. It's more shiny, always. You can put down, move around and move in the shadow, and you will probably see the shiny areas at the, of the leather boots and everything. Okay, after the leather boot, I went over to the metal parts. The metal parts, I chose the color silver, and also the color natural steel. It's a model color from Vallejo. Natural steel and silver in a mix. And then you have this beautiful, beautiful example of how metal can look like. Some parts of the metal of the miniature are more shiny than the other parts. You have different parts that are dark because they have no use at all for being beautiful. They have just the use to keep the fur on the back, or keep the belt in front of everything very tight to the body and everything else. But the metal that is in front of the miniature have to be very, very beautiful. And after drying, I put the highlights on it and use silver again. Just silver. Plata silver from Vallejo. Just use it to put it on special places at the metal to work out some highlights. It's easy, just put a few drops. And then, if you're finished and you're happy with the metal, you can work the clothes out. The clothes, they are not jumping in my eye. If I put my eyes on the miniature, it's not a thing at the miniature that are very, very important. So I just used bone white, mixed it with black and white to work out the upper part and the down part. And then after I'm finished, I used some gold, like you saw. I think glorious gold. I used it for the parts at the stomach, because, as I said, always story. The smith of this dwarf, the smith master of the village, yeah, he created this armor, and the armor have to be beautiful at some places, especially the places you present to everybody, the chest, and especially here the stomach. The stomach part have these small symbols, runes, and they have to be gold, I guess. Good. It's going on and on and on. The next step, I forgot something. I forgot the animal skin and fur at the hands, and also as a beautiful place above the rune on the stomach. Just use white and silver gray again. And after everything is cool, you can just put nun oil on it, work it out, put varnish on it, and everything have to, yeah, will look good. Okay, the skin was very tough. For the skin, I used different colors. I used Flat Flash from Model Color Vallejo, and also Elf Skin Tone, and mixed it also with Beastie Brown at some parts. First, that it was too much Flat Flash color. It was not dark enough for a dwarf, and I never worked out the muzzles I like. So I used some different color, like I said, a little bit brown and elf skin tone to work out the muscles, and moved over to the face. It is just the first painting step to just see the face, and I never worked out the highlights right now at the miniature. I just want to have paint on the miniature. That's why I moved over to the to the hair with bloody red and Beastie Brown in a mix to give him a cool red like, with a lot of brown in it, hair and beard both. Here you see a detailed picture of the face, and I tried it to put the color or the eye on the miniature. It's always tough. Come on, it's tough. Paint eyes is hard. You can see so much tutorials, but if you are at the point to do it by your own, you suck. like I did here. I will inform you, I will spoiler you. In the next couple of minutes, you will see good eyes. But I hate these eyes, so I moved over to the skin again to put the final touch at the skin. Right now I mixed Flat Flash with Beastie Brown in a way that fits better to a dwarf. The face, on the arms, everything looks better if you make it a little bit darker to see differences between higher parts of the skin. It's always better to have some mix in the levels of dark and shiny. And if you want to make it brighter, just put more white in it. Just put a small amount of white. You don't have to use another color and another color. Just mix it. I don't know whether it was a 1:5 mix. It was so less white that I worked it out over and over again. You can see some steps where the pencil is gone, or the brush is gone, or the miniature moves around. These are the parts where I choose more white on the brush. Then, after finishing the muzzles, I choose some black to work out the muzzles again and again to put lines. And you see the arm looks good, I think. And it's the face. It's the same thing for the face. Work out some highlights, and then I moved over to the eyes again. I just brave and put white. Said to me, okay, come on, do it. And then took black, put dots for the iris in the eye, and hope that you will hit the correct place in the eye. And I think at the end it was everything okay. I just jumped over a few parts because I tried again and again, and yeah, then it was okay for me. I also painted the wolf head, the teeth with white, the tongue with red, the eyes with magic blue, and you see the lips, the flesh from the wolf mouth. It's a mix of white, red, and oh, that's it. More like a pink, a very soft flesh. Good, what is very important again? Work out hairs. The high parts of the hair, the up part of the hill, like I said, have to be brighter than the normal beard and the normal hair color. That's why I mixed the old color I have with brown and red with white again to make it brighter. I'm not a profi. I'm a rookie, I think, in painting, but maybe in a few next videos I will use different colors for it. Then the end of a hair have to stick out. That's why I paint some parts very, very shiny now. Also the parts in the face where the beard is growing out of the things to put the hair together. Something have to stick out to make the hair look good. Okay, after painting the hair, I moved to the weapon because I thought that we are reaching the end. The weapon have some clothes or something else to have a better grip if you take your weapon. That's why yeah, you can see this. I use bone color and make it darker and darker with black, normal black, bone color and normal black. On the top of the shaft it was bright, and if you turn it around it's more black and black, so it's darker. Then after drying, put some wash on it. I washed it with vanilla black, own wash, just clean water and abandoned black, and everything is okay. The shaft by itself is not steel. I choose wood because every miniature have steel shafts. It's expensive to produce steel shafts for a smith always. And why use steel for a shaft if you can use it for a better blade or something else? You have not so much steel weapon in the Middle Age. So why here? Why in Warhammer or fantasy games? So I choose a normal brown, beastie brown again, put some other color in it to make highlight, and that's a shaft. And then if we move over to the weapon, if a lot of people will jump to this part, I think. The blade first, totally let slap silver on the blade. Just silver on every metal part of the weapon. Slap it on, you don't have to make very, very clear lines. Just this blade have to be silver. Put it there. Yeah. And it's not boring to paint this miniature. Thanks to Paschspiele, it's very cool to paint. Okay, after the silver is drying, use some soft wash of brown. And nun oil. I forgot to put the nun oil in the video. I used nun oil with abandoned black in a mix, and then I use quick shade soft tone from Army Painter to work out that the blade is old. And then after totally drying, I'm finished and want to glue it on the base. I use a very super glue, and that's the final miniature, how it looks like right now on our base. I hope everything looks cool for you. I like it. It's right now next to my desk, and look at me always. If you have ideas how it goes better, just write it down. I hope this first video in English was okay. It's not my mother tongue, but I wish you have a good time. We will see us in the next videos. Just subscribe if you want, would be cool. Or yeah, if you want, you can come back to the next video. Leave a comment and stay healthy. We will be right back.